हर्षद मेहता। इन 1990s, पीपल यूज्ड टू कॉल हिम एज अमिताभ बच्चन ऑफ द स्टॉक मार्केट बिकॉज इन द स्टॉक मार्केट बिजनेस ही हैड बिकेम बिगेस्ट करोड़पति। ही वॉज अर्निंग मोर देन द बॉलीवुड स्टार्स एट द टाइम एंड ऑल्सो ही वॉज हैविंग लग्जूरियस कार्स लाइक लेक्सस एंड स्टारलेट ब्रांड कार्स। इन 1990s, ही वॉज द वन ऑफ द इंडियस हाइएस्ट टैक्स पेयर बट ओनली इन 2 years हिज लाइफ हैज बिकेम स्पॉइल्ड। Though how much he had earned, but at last he was in prison walls. Let us know how he had become Karorpati and why police has arrested him and what is his story. Now I am going to tell in this episode. Let's begin our episode. Harshad Mehta, in 1954, he was born in Gujarat. After some years, the family migrated to Mumbai. In Mumbai itself, he continued his education. Harshad Mehta, in 1976, he had completed his BCom. After completing his education, in 4 years, he started to work in cloth shop, cement shop, jewelry shops, insurance company, and also as salesperson's jobs. He was having a habit of reading newspaper daily. Daily, he used to read about stock market because in stock market, so many people are becoming rich. That had came to him. He started reading up books, biography of the people who had become crorepati in the stock market. In these 4 years, he became well aware of the stock market. In 1980, he had joined to brokerage firm as a clerk. What is brokerage firm? This firm will tell about in which stock market we invest will earn more profit. They used to give some advice to customers, but for that, they used to charge some amount of money. What's the another work of brokerage firm? Example, like how Flipkart works like a platform between buyers and sellers. In the same way, brokerage firm works between the platform between stock buyers and sellers. He had 4 years in that same company. While doing job itself, he started investing in stock market. For his friends, he was giving advice in which stock market we need to invest. From that advice, his friends was earning profit. In 4 years, cause of investing in stock market, he had earned more money. Like how Sachin Bansal has resigned his job from Amazon and started Flipkart. By his own, in the same manner, even Harshad Mehta has resigned his job in 1984. By his own, started brokerage company as called as Grow More Research and Asset Management. In the beginning, he was giving good advice to customers that had made his company to start earning revenue. In one way, he was earning from his company, and from another way was earning in stock market from his investment. Step by step, he started becoming rich till 1990. All the things was going good. But at the time, Harshad Mehta thought of earning more money. Because of that, he thought of using stock market loops. For suppose, company had over 100 shares. For one share is equal to 1 rupee, then the total value of shares is 100 rupees. Suppose if any person starts buying the same shares for 2 rupees, then the same person buy the entire share, it will become double 200 rupees. By looking this, stockholders will thought of buying. By assuming company is earning good profit, the person who had bought the share for rupees 2, he will sell it for 3. Then he will earn the profit of rupees 100. In the same way, chain will continue till the trick falls. This is what stock market manipulation. This loopholes Harshad Mehta thought of using, but for that he required more money. But that much money he didn't add. So for that he thought of using banking system loopholes. That is how. Suppose for any government project, if the government require money, at that time government will give one announcement. That is, for the project we required money. For that we will pay interest every year. After some years, we will return back your principal amount. At the time, like us common people and banks will give amount to government. For giving that money, government will give bonds to the investors. That is government securities or government bonds. In 1990s, suppose if the bank required money suddenly, at that time, bank which is having government security, that government security will keep as surety with another bank for the loan. After some days, the bank which is taken loan will repay the principal amount with interest. After, it will take back their securities. In the simple manner, suppose we require money means at the time we will place the gold and we will take the money back. In the same way, bank will also doing by keeping their securities. This is what ready forward deal. This ready forward deal between two banks. Here a broker companies acts as a mediator. Here the broker's work is finding the bank which is required money and the bank which is ready to give loan for that. Here between two banks, broker is Arshad Mehta. Here in Ready Forward deal, there are some loopholes. By using it, he made a big scam. That is how. Now I am going to give one simple example. Suppose there are four banks like A, B, C, D. Here for bank A required money. At the time, bank will go to Arshad Mehta by saying we required loan. For that, we'll keep our securities as surety. For that, Arshad Mehta will tell, give me some time, I'll find the loan. In another way, bank B will approach Arshad Mehta by saying we'll give loan, find who required the loan. At the time, Arshad Mehta has taken checks from bank B by saying, give me some time, I'll find the bonds for this. As per the RBI rule, the bank by taking bonds, they need to issue loan checks on the name of the bank, not on the name of the broker. But at the time, Arshad Mehta was having good name. For that, bank B has issued loan check on him. Here the banks won't give directly their bonds paper to loan giving bank. For that, they will issue bank receipts as a bond surety. Here, Arshad Mehta has created fake bank receipts as security. By giving this receipt, he has taken loan. From that loan amount, he was using for manipulating stock market. He was buying all the shares. Suppose in center, if bank B asks him to pay a amount, at the time he was going to bank C. By giving fake receipts, he was taking loan amount. From that loan amount, he was paying for bank B. In the same manner, he was doing with all the banks. In simple terms, so many people take loans from their relatives and friends. For suppose, Ramesh has taken loan from Suresh. To repay that amount, Ramesh has taken loan from Naresh. Again, in the same manner, he taken from another person. Here the chain system will be continue. In the same way, Arshad Mehta was rotating the money. He was taking share value to the peak. After that, he was selling. From that profit, he was paying back loan amount to banks by taking back his fake receipts at that time. At that time, ACC company share value manipulated from 200 rupees to 9000 rupees. In this manner, he was manipulating so many company shares. People used to buy that shares by knowing share market is growing daily. Arshad Mehta was selling his shares when it is going to peak. In 1991 and 1992, he had earned more money from this process. At the time, Sucheta Dalal, journalist, had finded his tricks and published it in newspaper. By knowing that news, from fear, people started selling their shares. From so many days, stock market was in profit. But from this news, it became so much applause. Here where Arshad Mehta invested in stock market, that share value has fall down. From that, so many people lost in stock market. At this time, Arshad Mehta couldn't able to repay the loan amount to bank. At the time, banks also came to know that all the receipts are fake and it doesn't have any value. At the time, case has registered on Arshad Mehta. In investigation, it became true. So many days he was in jail. At the time, from bail he came out, but still on him, court cases are going on. In 2001, he struck in one case where he couldn't get the bail. At the time, they kept in higher jail. One day, Arshad Mehta got heart attack. They took him to hospital, but he died. In 2001, December 31st, at the age of 47 years. From this scam, common people, they lost so much in stock market. Total over, he had a debt of 4,500 crores to banks. Present currency value of that money is 24,000 crores. Now their family members are repaying that amount. From the information, still they need to pay 1,000 crores. Because of Arshad Mehta scam, having loopholes in stock market and in banking sector, it got revealed. After knowing this story, government had rectified this. This what happens when we think to become rich in overnight. If you guys had liked my explanation, please like, share and subscribe. And I am new to this YouTube channel, please support me. Thank you.